If you look at Iraq's in the region, and as soon as the Iraqis are Arab nationalists, Kurdish nationalists, and you name it, there are relatively high percentage of educated people of different cultures and people.
Saddam is, does not have the capacity to deliver them to distant countries. The only way he can spread these outside Iraq's boundaries is using terrorist cells that he will train specifically for this purpose. And he does have a number of terrorist cells that he has used in the past. But I don't think that danger is as imminent as the danger to the Iraqi people themselves. These weapons have been used against the Iraqis in the past, in the 80s, and also in suppressing the uprising of 1991. And Saddam might use them again against the Iraqi people in the event of military confrontation, because he knows his real opponents are the Iraqi people. They may rise up again as they did in 1991. And he is keeping these weapons to kill the Iraqis in mass if they rise up again to free themselves from his tyrannies.
Whether they are Kurds, in my case, the Marsh Arabs.
A war that can cause civilian casualties or damage to the Iraqi infrastructure, I would not support. A war that will, a surgical operation, I would rather call it, not a war, that will target Saddam himself and allow the Iraqi people to free themselves and decide their destiny, decide and choose their rulers, is an operation that many Iraqis would welcome.